In this video, we will see how to compute the energy yield of a wind turbine. We will also consider the wind turbine placement and its impact on the overall power produced by a farm. In particular, after watching this video, you will be able to compute the energy yield of a wind turbine based on its power curve and the wind characteristics, and also to explain the concept of velocity deficit and its impact on wind farm layout. But first, let's summarize what we discussed in previous videos. We saw how to characterize the wind with probability density functions. We saw what a power curve is, and also the meaning of a capacity factor. The computation of the energy yield, that is the energy produced by a wind turbine, requires a good understanding of all these concepts. So imagine that we know the power curve of a wind turbine, that is the power produced by the wind turbine for each wind speed. Suppose that we also know the wind characteristics at the turbine location. This is represented by a histogram, or probability density function, showing how many times a certain wind speed occurs at that location. Then the product of these two curves gives, for each wind speed, the total power produced. The zero below cut-in speed, and then positive values for the other ranges of wind speeds. If the histogram contains the wind characteristics over an entire year, then the integral of the plot on the right-hand side gives the total annual production of the wind turbine. So generally speaking, if we know the power curve of the turbine and we know the wind characteristics at the location of the turbine, then we can compute the energy yield. But what if we don't have this information? It is indeed sometimes very difficult to get wind speed measurements at the location where we would like to install a wind turbine. Without this information, it is still possible to compute a rough estimate of the energy yield using the capacity factor. Remember that the capacity factor is an indicator of the percentage of time a wind turbine runs at full power. So knowing the rated power of the turbine, we can multiply this value by the capacity factor to get a rough estimate of the energy yield. If we further multiply this quantity by the number of hours in a year, the estimate is expressed in terms of watt hour per year, which is a measure of energy. As we saw previously, typical values of the capacity factors are 0.25 onshore and up to 0.45 offshore. Again, remember that the capacity factor depends on the size of the turbine and also its location. So now we know how to compute or estimate the energy produced by a wind turbine. But what about the energy produced by a farm of, let's say, 10 wind turbines? Is it simply 10 times the power produced by one of the wind turbines? Well, the answer is generally no, because of the interaction between the turbines. We've seen in a previous video that a wind turbine rotor disturbs the incoming wind flow. It exerts a force, which is necessary to produce power, and therefore slows down the flow. We've also seen what a typical undisturbed profile of wind velocity looks like. The wind speed equals zero at the ground and then gradually increases with the altitude. This picture applies to in the absence of wind turbines. Downstream of the rotor, the wind velocity profile is substantially modified. The force exerted by the rotor creates a velocity deficit that is a significant reduction in wind speed. If another wind turbine is placed in this wake region, it will experience a reduced incoming wind speed, and consequently, it will produce less power. The presence of a velocity deficit also implies that there are strong gradients of velocity in the profile, especially at the bottom and the top of the rotor. These shear layers are the source of vortex generation, meaning that turbulent eddies are shed in the wake. These vortices tend to suppress the velocity deficit by bringing air from outside the deficit region into the deficit region. The full wake recovery can, however, take a distance of several turbine diameters. This has consequences on the turbine placement in a farm. Of course, as this slide shows, the impact of the wake on other turbines depend on the wind direction. As this changes, the region in which the wake develops moves around, hence increasing or decreasing the velocity seen by any given wind turbine. Finding the optimal wind turbine layout in a farm is no easy task, and indeed an active area of research. In general, a good placement results from a compromise between power generated and area of land used. Today, we can limit the loss in the power produced by a farm due to wake effects to only 5 to 10%. In this video, we learned how to compute the energy yield of a wind turbine based on its power curve and the wind characteristics, or also the capacity factor. We discussed the concept of velocity deficit, its impact on the wind farm layout, and its dependence on the wind speed, on the wind direction, even. In the next video, we will learn about electrical aspects related to wind energy production.